At Wings of Transformation Publishing, we are committed to helping our authors reach their goals and pursue their dreams of becoming published authors. We work closely with each author to ensure a successful publishing experience, and we are dedicated to helping them tell their stories in the most meaningful and impactful ways. We look forward to putting you on the path to writing your book.
Aspiring Authors Magazine is a founding sponsor for DaCru Podcast. Get featured inside the magazine and allow your voice to be heard around the world.
Aspiring Authors Magazine is an international magazine founded in May of 2020 by Queen Angela. Get featured.
Hey, and welcome to the Crew Podcast. We are the hottest podcast rocking right now. We are currently looking for six amazing hosts to join our family for season two that will kick off February the 1st, 2024. If you're looking for an opportunity to allow your voice, your perspective, and your brand to be heard around the world and seen around the world, then join the Crew Podcast.
Tune in to Delay But Not Deny every second Monday and fourth Friday of each month. This is the show that you don't want to miss.
Hey, everybody. I want to thank you all for tuning in to the last episode of Delay But Not Denied, the podcast on tonight. This is episode 181 for the Crew Podcast. Tonight, I have our phenomenal leader, Miss Queen Angela. And we will be talking tonight and just having a conversation. I also, before I start, I want to say thank you for all of the people who've been on my show, who wanted to be on my show, who's made my show what it is today. I thank you. I thank the ones who brought me out of my shell. I could not have done this without you. Today is my mom's birthday. She would have been 63 today. So I would like to take a moment to wish my mother, Margaret Marie Kennedy, a very happy heavenly 63rd birthday. Mommy, I love you. I miss you. So tonight is for you as well. Again, tonight, we're coming close to the end. There's 24 hours left in this year. So anything that you have put off until tomorrow, get it done. Get it done. Don't take it into 2024 if you can help it. Without going any further, I would like to go to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come to you tonight thanking you for this opportunity, blessing your name, Father God, and just showering you with love and just heartfelt gratitude for what you have allowed us to do as a team and for me individually. Lord, I ask you that you carry us into 2024 even stronger than we left in 2023. And I just want to say thank you. And, you know, we're nothing without you, Father God. So with that being said, I thank you. I bless your name. In Jesus' name, I pray. Without further ado, Miss Angela, come talk to me.
Amen, amen, amen. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you tonight?
Well, I can't complain. I tell you, I can never complain. It could be worse.
Right.
I'm sure somebody else is going through something worse than what I'm going through. Absolutely. You know, anytime we wake up on this side, anytime we get another chance.
Absolutely.
Stop saying a second chance, because, you know, that second chance was that second chance.
Right.
But then he gave us another chance because some of us had third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, mm-hmm. eighth, 10, 20, 30, 100, 1,000 chances.
Mm-hmm.
So he keep giving us another chance to get it right. So I have another chance. You know, I Absolutely. Got to see another day that was not promised me. Absolutely. You know, every day I've learned, and I have to give a shout out to Miligos Romero's, because she is truly someone that has taught me what gratitude is, mm-hmm. and taking the little things and appreciating them. The rising of the sun, the setting of the same, you know, and just different things that sometimes we take for granted that a lot of people wish they had the opportunity to right. enjoy. So right. I just learned to begin to appreciate those things around me and to realize the things that I had around me. You know, sometimes God placed these gifts on the inside of us and we don't utilize these gifts.
Right.
And they can be helping so many people. The things that we think are minute, or the things that we think are little, or the things that we think that don't matter, sometimes can change millions of lives if we just step out on faith. And I thank God for the upbringing that I've had and the belief system that he instilled in those that he allowed to be my disciples, because Absolutely. That is our jobs.
Mm-hmm.
As people, and we have to understand that regardless of what religion you choose to follow, what religion you choose to take upon, or whatever you want to call it, you know, we got names for everything, but Absolutely. At the end of the day, it all go back to one God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he allow all of this. He allow all these different religions. And if we go back to our Bible and we truly understand that he had to do that, he had to break it up, because when everybody is truly on one accord and everybody is truly in sync, and everybody, and those that truly know the Bible know this, that they were building the temple and the temple was getting so high, they was getting so close and they was getting so close that he had to begin, he had to break up the languages.
Mm-hmm.
So when people get they panties in the water about the different religions and want to fight and argue, I can't argue about religion.
Right.
Me you know, either. Not my belief systems. You know, and it goes back to, I remember this lady, and she's a woman of the cloth. I don't call names, but she said this, and it was profound, and I share it all the time. But when your mama put you in that carrier, she placed you in that carrier, you sit there. And then as you began to grow, you moved up to your high chair, and then you moved up to your little chair, and then you moved up to the next chair, and then you moved to the next chair. And then when you start walking, you walked up to the chair, and you just sit down. You didn't question that chair, just like you didn't question putting you in those chairs. But you questioned everything else.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll walk up to a plane, and we'll get on the plane and we'll drive these cars across bridges, and we'll do all these different things that we are doing by faith.
Right.
We're doing by faith. That is faith. But we won't activate that same faith in things that we do for God, things mm-hmm. that we do for the kingdom. Because everything that we do, whether we want to accept it or not, everything that we do is for the kingdom. at the end of the day, it's for the kingdom. It's for the building of the kingdom, because that's why we all placed here. We all have a route back to the Father.
Absolutely.
And how we get there is upon us, because guess what? You can change your route. You can change the detours. You can change the route. But with everything that we do that's out of the will, know that there's a consequence.
Mm-hmm.
But if you stay on the straight and narrow, it can be a whole lot easier. And I learned that along the way on this journey. But it took me some time. Like, I'm finna be 49. It took me some time. But God is good. And he will extend his grace and his mercy to allow you to get back on track. And he thank enough of you to bring you out of that darkness. Because some of us, we be deep in our sin that we forget about all this stuff that's going on around us.
Right.
And we get so consumed.
Right.
We allow consumption to take over us. Because let me tell you something, I was there. I was that person. And see, I just have to be transparent, because guess what? Nobody was transparent with me, so I stayed in that dark place. But mm-hmm. see, when you can be transparent with somebody else and you can tell the truth and you can be honest with yourself, then it helps other people to heal. It helps other people to move past. Yeah, I be depressed still to this day.
Me too.
I've been in therapy. I've laid on many a couches. I've had psychologists. I've had psychiatrists. I've had therapists after therapists after therapists. But I have to make a determination that say, I'm going to keep going. When I realize that I'm going through something, and then you have to be able to recognize stuff too. And you have to want to change. You have right. to want to move past. You have to want to say, okay, I'm going to take hold of this. I know I got this issue. I know I'm dealing with this. Then, okay, let me deal with this. Let me get through this. Let me surround myself with people that have been through this or going through this, and I can call upon these people. And see, that's what we got to do. We got to get back to that village.
All right.
And see, a lot of people have gotten away from that village mentality because guess what? We've been hurt. We've been hurt by family. We've been hurt by close friends. We've just been hurt, and we built up that wall, and we don't want to let people in, because guess what? People continue to do the same thing. People continue to manipulate. People continue to throw their problems off on you.
Mm-hmm.
But you just have to continue to move by faith and believe and ask for discernment so that he will show you when somebody is acting out of order.
Right.
Because he will not allow his child to be fooled. That's one thing he will not do. And I've learned this on this journey.
Okay.
And, you know, that's just something that, you know, I don't know. I don't know why I went in like that, but, you know, God
because God told you to.
We just have to, sometimes we just have to humble ourselves and
right.
understand that, you know, this is a journey that we got to go through.
Right.
You know, we can read the Bible. Yeah, it was given to us as a blueprint, but guess what? They didn't have a guide. They didn't have that. All they had was experiences and Jesus leading them. But mm-hmm. guess what? You're not Jesus, so your experience is gonna be different. I'm not Joseph. I'm not Mary. I'm not Sarah. Even though we have their blueprint, we have what they done, but I'm a different breed. And those coming after me are a different breed. I mean, everybody has evolved. And as people evolve, we have to understand that life evolves too. And we have to right. we have to grasp different ways to work with people and understand people and meet people where they are and share life experiences. Because guess what? What worked thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago may not work now.
Right.
May not work now. So we got to go with what's going to work now, because we're living in the now. And that's where a lot of what's happening now overseas is happening the way it's happening. People think that it's happening because of one reason, and it's happened because of one reason. No, it's happened because people were disobedient back in the Bible day. And now that stuff is coming to pass. You know, everything that we sow, we shall reap. Mm-hmm. Whether it's your children's 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 children,
It's coming back. Absolutely.
These people were doing this mass conservation. You think you're getting away? You're not.
Yeah.
Everything that you're doing is going to come back to bite you. Whether it's your great-great-grandchildren or your great-great-grand, they are going to suffer.
Yeah. And I had that conversation with somebody. Like, we may not feel what that karma is directly, but we'll definitely know it indirectly because, I mean, God gonna spin the block. I mean, he's not gonna allow you to go but so far before he pulls you back and,
right,
you know, and put you in your place. Because, I mean, you can only step out of line so many times before that whip crack. So,
right.
But I wanted to bring you on tonight to give you your flowers. You have created a safe space for a lot of different people from all different walks of life, from different age groups, different tax brackets. And we all have the same goal in mind, and it's just to go further. And none of this would be possible without you. And so I wanted to take this moment to just say thank you, to tell you that we love you, we honor you, and, you know, the queen of collaboration, you have opened doors that some of us haven't even thought about entering. Like, you know, everybody knows that I follow Travita into the podcast world, but it was you that gave me the training to get me to where I am today. Here I am, never thought that this is something that I've stuck to and stuck it out. Like, I never finish anything. I never see anything through. I procrastinate. I'm really bad at it. And, you know, that's my cross to bear. But you saw something in me and it made me want to show up. I show up for everybody when I can. And even though I got the flu at this very moment, I showed up tonight. This is my last show for 2023. And I can only see bigger and better things happening for 2024. So I wanted to start this conversation with asking you, where do you see the Crew Podcast going in 2024? What direction do you see? What's your vision for the Crew?
Well, as a visionary, of course, my vision is very humongous. Mm-hmm. I just don't see it as a podcast. I see us venturing into even doing television, mm-hmm. doing red carpet events. Mm-hmm. I'm definitely pushing the Crew out there coming up next season because everyone knows that I do this expo that I've been doing for about 4 years. I started in 2016, 2017. Mm-hmm. But during COVID, I had to stop because of COVID. But we're going to get back out there. We're going to get back on the road. Those that follow AALAC, which is the African American Author Literacy Awareness Campaign, I do a Chasing Your Dream book tour and expo where I bring in individuals that do workshops. They facilitate workshops. We do breakout sessions. I bring in authors, business owners. So I bring in about 30 authors, about 15 business. We have speakers that do the breakout shops. Like I say, this year I want to include the Crew Podcast to host the red carpet area, to do the interviews, to go around and give the authors and the business owners an extra opportunity for exposure. And y'all can cover the event. And then not only that, the magazine. Now I have the magazine. I didn't have the magazine before. The magazine came out in 2020. So we're celebrating 4 years next year. And all this happened during COVID. I dropped this in my spirit to be able to do these things, to share to around the world during the lockdown, because a lot of people, they were unsure of what they were going to do. So I really racked my brain and just came up with a lot of stuff to, you know, help the people that were in my circle. You know,
right.
I could only think about those that were connected to me. And I came up with these different things, and that's what we did. But now we're getting back out there. Like I said, we're gonna be hitting the cities, hitting different states. We have 10 stops. We're gonna start in Myrtle Beach, April the 6th. We're headed to Texas. We're headed to Illinois, New York, Tennessee, Alabama, Savannah, North Carolina, Spartanburg, Charleston. Hopefully we can end on somebody's ship on a cruise, or
be nice
in Myrtle Beach. But those are my desires. We have some ambassadors that's helping me. And I'm still putting a plea out there. If you are in a state and you would like to be a state ambassador, simply if you know different places, venues in your state, you know, different connections, you know, different things that could help me, because I'm not in your state. I'm in Myrtle Beach, but I need to get these locations booked. I need to get these venues solidified so that we can get them packed out, get the community involved. I am also trying to make sure that I connect with the news stations. I'm reaching out to those news stations back in Anderson and Greenville that I worked with when I lived in Anderson, and see if they can help me connect with those different ones in those different states that I'm trying to reach out to. I'm pulling out all hats. I'm getting back to the basics. I'm getting back to, you know, how I got here, you know,
right?
Those things that God allowed me to do to get me where I am today. So I'm sticking to it, you know, and I'm trying to show other people how to do it too. So we're doing workshops at these events. So we're going to have branding workshops so people can learn how to brand their business, learn how to do other stuff. If you are an author, you can do so much more besides talk about selling your book. You can do so much more. You can create a coaching program. You can create a speaking platform. You can create merchandise around your book. You can create so much. So we're going to have a branding workshop. We're going to have a marketing workshop. Of course, we're going to be doing podcasting, because guess what? You are listening to the newly enshrined class of 2023 International Internet Radio Hall of Fame broadcasting inductee. I'm excited about that. Not only that, I won Host of the Year over on WBNN. I'm telling you, I'm going to be celebrating 4 years over on that network.
Congratulations.
And I'm excited about that. I'm telling you, somebody believed in me. Somebody gave me a chance. So I have no choice but to believe in others and to give others a chance. Because guess what? If I had a gave up a long time ago and said, forget this, throw it in the towels, I wouldn't be sitting right here.
Right.
But it's just something about that will and the will. Y'all, he's given us power. And I tell people these words that, you know, we take for granted, that we throw around. Like, he kept giving me this word. He kept giving me this word. And I was like, okay, power. And then he broke it down to me. He said, I have positioned you, the P, position, you to be an overcomer. Oh, you overcome everything that you've been through. Yeah, it all came at you. It was part of the plan. Jeremiah 29:11 will not return to him void. He said it was not to harm you, it wasn't to harm you, but it was to prosper you. It was to help provide you with hope in a future. See, if you didn't go through nothing, you couldn't hope for nothing. So you had to go through. So you overcame that. But guess what? You didn't complain. You was a willing vessel. You stood there. You let them talk about you. You let them call your names. You let them throw darts at you. You let them do everything to you. But they never helped you. They never gave you a helping hand. They never pushed you. They never wanted to see you succeed. But you stood. You didn't give up. You was that willing vessel. He said, guess what? He said, I've given you the tools to educate. He said, no, it ain't about degrees. He said, and I showed you it wasn't about degrees. He said, I allowed you to go back 30 years later to get your degree. You did, but you had to go through. You had to let other people see that it wasn't about a degree. It wasn't about the titles. What about all that? But you're in a vessel to educate, empower, and encourage others to not give up. That will in the will that will not let you quit is called resilience. And that's power. And when people understand the power that's on the inside of them, Genesis 2:7 will not return to him void. He said he breathed the breath of life into you. Mm-hmm. So a part of him is on the inside of you.
It ain't you
that wake you up. But all you got to do is you have to move out your way.
Right.
And let him in. Yeah. Invite him in. Welcome him in. Give him a place to dwell. Give him a place to be. And he'll be just what he said he would be. And people got to understand that. And until they do, they're going to continue to go in the same circles, and then they're going to wonder why ain't nothing working right.
I promise
why
you.
Nothing is doing this and why nothing is doing
this. I promise
you. You know, everybody want to know right how now. You got all these books, how you do this, how you do that, how you do this. How? It ain't by my strength, because guess what? I have no power.
Right.
But he dropped things in my spirit, and I have to move on. Like, all these books right here, I did these this year. All these right here. I did these this year. I did a calendar. And I got another one on the way. But I did this. I made this calendar from scratch. I just sit here one day and designed it. You know, I asked people if they wanted to be a part of it. And, you know, I put people in it. You know. But all these books, he dropped in my spirit, and I did it. And I look on Amazon. Amazon say I got 87 books. My goal is to have 100 by the time I turn 50. So we're gonna see. I'm gonna sit down one day, and I'm gonna figure out exactly how many books I really got. Like when I turn 49, and then I got a whole year to write. But I do believe I'll get the 100. But I just like everybody helping, like doing stuff. Like we got a book that's dropping tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
The third book to this series here, it is a poetry book that is bringing awareness to Black mental health. Like it's titled "Silently Hurt Inside, Hurt No More." You know, people are like, how you come up with that? Like, God dropped it in my spirit. Like, so many people hurt in silence, and they don't want to talk about it. They want to hold it inside, and they don't want to say nothing about it, you know?
I don't think that it's that they want to hold it inside. We're in a generation of where we can't talk to everybody because everybody don't care. And then, you know, you have your group of people that can't wait to run and tell what you're going through. So it's not so much that they want to keep it inside, but it's a safe place to keep it bottled up, because at the end of the day, you're not going to use it against you. You get what I'm saying? Like the
next person. It's so many opportunities. We're living in an age right now where there's so many opportunities where there's no more time for making excuses. We're living in an era where you can go anywhere and find somebody. Like now you can pick up your phone, dial 988, and somebody on the other line to sit there and listen to you and not say nothing if that's what you want. You know, they're there to help you, you know, and that's what I'm trying to do through all of what I do, you know, to share with people so that people know that, hey, you are not alone, you know, and when this book drops tomorrow, people are going to understand, you know, it's 40 of us inside of this book. You know, we come from different walks of life. You got 7 men, and 5 of those men are incarcerated, you know, and they're sharing in poetry. You got 2 ladies from Lagos, Nigeria, all the way from Africa, you know, sharing poetry, you know, their perspective, you know, and we're talking about love from a place of being hurt because you got a school teacher. One of the ladies from Africa, she's a school teacher and she's battled with depression, you know, so she understands on so many different levels what this Black mental health is really all about, you know, and people think that, you know, this only, no, it's not just an American thing either. And we not just focused on what's happening here in America. We focused on what's happening around the world because we are an international magazine. We're an international podcast. We are focused on what's happening around the globe. And that's what we do. You know, we are here to make an impact. We are here to be the change that we want to see around this world, you know, and we're leading by example. We're not sitting back and waiting for something to fall out the sky.
Right.
It's never going to fall out the sky.
Right. So, you know, like,
so
being that you are the woman that you are, you've shared your story with us many times on many different shows. How do you find the strength to keep going? Like, you know, you've shared in domestic violence month that you were shot at point blank range with a sawed off shotgun. And I mean, yes, God spared your life. But what is it within yourself that keeps you from not just sitting in that depressive state and blaming yourself for not seeing signs before and just being able to walk away and being who you are today?
Well, I had to own up to the fact that, you know, in every situation, we all have a part.
Right.
We all play a part, and I did play a part. I was more so the enabler. I was more so the person that thought I could fix someone. That was me. My problem was called what they call codependency. That was me. Thought that I could change something that I couldn't change. Not realizing that the signs were there. And then in the place where pride was still there too, you know, I'm back in my hometown where I said I would never be. I'm dealing with a lot of stuff that I said I wouldn't be dealing with, you know.
Right.
And I was in that dark place. And for us to say that we'll never do this, because I'm telling you, if you had known me before domestic violence and before I went through all this, you would have never thought I would be that person in that place. Like, nobody thought that happened to me. Like, when a lot of people saw this on the news and people were seeing this on the news, they was like, no, not now. She wasn't doing like that's somebody else. That was, but yeah, that was me. I was in a dark place, but even afterwards, I had to realize that this was not what I wanted. And I had to walk away because in being transparent and being honest may trigger some people, but just trigger warning. I went back even after all of this. You know, I was married. This was my husband. I forgave him. We were going to work it out. After a while, I was like, no, I can't do this. I packed up what I could and I left. I went to Atlanta and I never looked back. And that was 2018. I walked away for good and said, this is this and this is that. And I never looked back. And I think my turnaround really came in 2017, really. In the back of my mind, I was planning, like, the getaway. I was planning on leaving, but I didn't know how, you know, and then how they'll wheel you back in and make everything seem like it's going to be okay and, you know, this is going to happen and everything going great for a while. And then there they go. They show themselves again. But if we understand and we truly, when people show you who they are.
You got to believe them.
That's who they are. Mm-hmm. That's who they are. They're not changing. It's not going back. It's not, they can't take it back. Once they reveal to you who they are, that's who they are. You got to take it for what it is. And you have to make those decisions. So I choose now to sit back and watch people and monitor people and to really take people for who they are. If they show me right. who they are, like you show me other than like, you don't tell me you this way and then you show me something else, then I'm believing what you show me.
Right.
And how did you not tell me no went out the window?
Yeah, because action speaks louder than words.
Exactly. And when you start seeing me less, then you should know.
Right.
Like, that's what it is. 2024 for me is going to be a whole lot different. Like a lot of people have rode my coattail. Just being honest. And just being real, a lot of people have thought that they have used me and they picked my brains and they've done all kind of stuff, but they've only been able to do what God would allow me to do. Mm-hmm. You know, I was just being obedient. But a lot of stuff is changing in 2024, right? A lot of people, I'm walking away from a lot of people that truly mean me no good, right? They right. have ill intentions and they have truly shown themselves, like they show themselves daily. Like if you just watch people, they will reveal to you exactly who they are. And you won't even have to say nothing. If you just sit and just listen and observe sometimes. And then sometimes if you just watch their pages. Like you don't even have to have no conversation with people sometimes. Sometimes you just watch their actions. Because actions always speak and they speak loud. Mm-hmm. And people don't understand that. But yeah.
I think they do. I think that they just don't
choose to ignore
think that everybody. Guess. Yeah, yeah. I think that they think that if you don't speak on it, then the other person don't know. Or whatever. Man. But you know, you can only well, I'll say this. People can only do to you what you allow them to do. And right. how long you allow them to do it is totally up to you. And so, right. you know, with that being said, you know, I've had a conversation where my 2024 will not look anything remotely close to what this year and years past has looked like. It won't. I mean,
2020 taught me something. 2021, 2022, 2023. Said in 2024, it's not going to be the same at all.
And I do believe that God allows you to keep learning the same lesson until you get it.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I've had a conversation with a friend, and we were talking about how if God is trying to take you away from something and you choose to ignore it and stay in the situation thinking that you can change a person, he's going to allow that person to do you harm until you decide to say, okay, I hear you. If it's truly time for me to go, then right. It's my time to go. And I mean, he doesn't, I feel like God doesn't create a situation to harm you himself, but because people were given free will, in that free will, they do what they want to do. And, you know, sometimes you just have, you happen to be in the way at that moment. So, you know, it changes you for how you look at people. And it makes it harder on friendships, relationships of any type moving forward, because you don't want to take that prior hurt, whether it be church hurt, family hurt, friendship hurt. You don't want to take that into new situations. You don't want to bleed on people that didn't cut you at the end of the day.
Right.
So my last question for you is, being that you were able to come out of a dark place and not look back, what recommendations do you have for someone who is trying to pull themselves out of darkness but can't seem to see the light at the end of the tunnel?
Well, first thing I tell them that they need to wake up and remind themselves that they are loved. They need to talk to themselves on a daily basis. Like, you got to speak life to yourself. Mm-hmm. You have that power. He's giving you that power. Proverbs 18:21 says that we have the power and the tongue to speak life or death. Mm-hmm. So we can speak life over ourselves. We get up in the morning and look ourselves in the mirror. Look at our souls. Look in your eyes, in that mirror, and speak to yourself. And then not only just speak to yourselves, act upon that thing that you speak to yourself. We got to learn how to love on ourselves and how to build ourselves up and understand that this is who we are. He's given us gifts and he's given us talents. He's given us a passion. So find that passion that's on the inside of you, that purpose that he's given you. Jeremiah 29:11 is not going to return to him, boy. He's given us all a purpose. There's a reason that we're here. We're not here by accident. If he's placed you here to be a podcaster, he's placed you here to be a podcaster or journalist, writing for the newspaper, on somebody TV show or whatever the case is, he's placed you here for that purpose, for the kingdom. So you find whatever your passion is. If your passion is helping people write books, if your passion is sharing affirmations, your passion is, you know, just being an encourager, whatever your passion is, that thing that drives you, that thing that wakes you up in the morning, that things that give you life, that thing that make you want to do more. People ask me, how do you do what you do? Because that will in the will. That power that he's given me a power to be a leader. He's given me a power to be a collaborator. Whoever spoke that over my life, they did something. I mean, they did that. They spoke that over my life, and I had to live up to that. So I have no choice. So now I have to live up to that name. So now I had to get out and start collaborating. I had to get out and start meeting people. Like, I don't meet a stranger.
But right.
How can I meet a stranger when I'm on a mission to bring people together? Like, it's my job to bring people together, for people to understand that there's a reason why they're here. It's not by accident. Like, you didn't get dropped out of the sky. Like, he placed you here. Like, literally, he placed you here for a reason. He didn't drop you down. Like, you here because He needed you on task. He needed you doing what he needed you to do. So that's why. So we just have to understand that. And I'm excited about this journey because I get an opportunity to take the gifts and the talents that he's given me, because some he's given one talent, some he's given two, some he's given three, and then some he's given a lot of talents to. But right. We have the opportunity to utilize those talents. So he's just happened to give us the opportunity to utilize them through the Crew podcast and through the magazine and through now the Chasing Your Dream book tour. We have the opportunity to take those skills that he's given us as broadcasters, as journalists, as individuals that's diving into the lives of others. We have a passion for sharing other stories because we believe that others have a story.
Absolutely.
And by sharing these stories, then we have the opportunity to bring about change and to give people the opportunity to hear the change that other people have been experiencing in their lives, and how their lives can change if they desire that change and if they're willing to do the work, because yeah, work comes with that.
Right.
Like I was sharing with Charita. Charita had posted something on Facebook the other day about overcoming something throughout the week or something of that nature. Mm-hmm. And I posted about really having about with depression this week.
Mm-hmm.
December is really a trying time for me because it's my mom's birthday. My mom's birthday is December the 4th. And then I got two cousins that was born on her birthday.
Mm.
So they're still here celebrating their birthday. So they get to celebrate their birthday and my mom's not here. And then so many of my cousins' birthdays in December. And then my favorite cousin, he was like my best friend, my brother. Like we was really, really close. He lived in Atlanta. He passed away October 2 years ago. I dedicated that book, Soulful Metamorphosis, that poetry book, to him. It was released on his birthday. But December sometime is very hard for me.
Yeah,
so
I get it.
I was kind of depressed. And like I was telling Charita in that post, you know, I had to cry a little bit. I had to let it out. And then I released. And then I took a nap. And then I got up and got in it again. You know, that's what we have to do. Sometimes we just have to release. Sometimes we just have to let it out. Sometimes it just need to come out.
And sometimes, like, I mean, you know, I don't know what the stigma is with Black people, but therapy helps. Get you a therapist. Talk to your therapist. You know, like I deal with depression and anxiety, and the month of December is hard for me as well. As you know, I'm adopted. My birth mother, her birthday is today. She's no longer here. My adoptive mother, her birthday was December 19th. My adoptive family, their wedding anniversary is tomorrow, and my adoptive father's no longer here. So, I mean, you know, I get it. And I went through a bout of crying yesterday. And it just, when you have all of these things bottled up inside of you, you have to release it or it'll kill you. That's the end, point blank, period. So you have to get it out, whether it be writing, singing, whatever it is that you do. Because like I never knew what my purpose was. I wrote a book thinking, okay, well, that's my purpose. That wasn't my purpose. You know, I've done a lot of different things and tried to do things that other people were doing, thinking, okay, if it worked for them, it may work for me. But this was different. Everybody has their own podcast within the crew. And, you know, shout out to everybody. I mean, Miss Alma, Live Again. She's teaching you how to navigate life after going through something traumatic. You know, Travita, believe in the journey. You got to believe in the journey ahead of you. No matter what it looks like, you got to believe what that is and trust right. the process. Let's chat with Nat. She's talking to you. She's telling you what's on her plate. And I mean, we all go through things. SC Book Gal and friends, if you got a book that you want reviewed, by all means, get it. Patrice, she got you. And
right.
You know, the mama of our crew, Miss Black Diamond, like, you know, we all bring something different to the table. Like, you know, it's a shameless plug. It's not too late to get some candles, some bedroom candles from Miss Black Diamond. You know, support these Black beautiful people that are giving you a portion of their lives throughout these podcasts, creating a platform for you to have a safe space to speak. My platform, Delayed But Not Denied, you know, what is delayed for you today is not necessarily being denied upon you. So just because it doesn't happen today doesn't mean that it's not going to. You just have to stay the course. And, you know, I open my platform to different people for different reasons, because everybody's situation is not the same. Everybody won't travel the same road, but the end goal is to walk amongst the kingdom of God. And, you know, right. Whatever we can do as a family to get to that point, you know, I'm here for it. Like, you know, I love all of y'all more than you could possibly even imagine. And I'm grateful for you, because you came into my life at a time where my life was in shambles. I mean, I'm still putting the pieces back together. It's a work in progress, but, you know, anything worth right. having is worth fighting for. So right now I'm fighting for me. So, you know, I thank you for just being not only the queen of collaborations, but the big sister that some of us don't have. Your ear to everybody, like, and nothing that is said to you goes anywhere. And, you know, that says a lot about who you are and your character as a woman, you know, because women are chatty. We don't always get along, you know, in certain situations, but we got the right group of people to come together and, you know, we pray for one another. We got the little group chat and we hop in there, and it's not always about the podcast. And that's beautiful that we can communicate beyond the confines of the podcast. And so I thank you for that.
Right.
So is there anything that you would like to say before we head out of here?
Well, I just thank God for the opportunity to be able to do the things that I do. I've not always been in this place. Mm-hmm. And I'm just thankful that he thought enough of me to bring me out of that dark place into the marvelous light, that I may be a beacon of light to somebody that may be in that dark place.
Right.
And to be able to spread hope. And I try to do that through love and by leading and by educating and empowering and encouraging others. So I just try to be a voice. And right. Again, I just urge everyone to make sure that they are following the Crew Podcast, stay connected to the Crew Podcast, AALAC, Chasing Your Dream Book Tour, y'all. We're going to be on the road. So stay connected to what we got going on. It's amazing hosts. I cannot leave out of here without giving a plug out to the amazing host. Season 2 will kick off February 1st. Y'all, we are be live right here on the Crew Podcast, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, live every single night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, starting February the 1st. Y'all gonna have an opportunity to meet some amazing people from February the 1st to December 31st, 2024. So mark your calendar, set your alarms, do whatever you got to do to be in the building, to be in the virtual arena so that you can be up close and personal with these amazing people from around the world, y'all. We're taking that trip around the globe. We're going to be stopping in different cities. We're going to get back to that village and get back to that community mentality. So, y'all, make sure y'all are following us. I appreciate y'all. And guess what? The Queen loves you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And guess what? There's absolutely nothing you can do about it.
Nothing. And, you know, also, if you would like to join the Crew Podcast as a host, we still have room. $199 gets you in. It gets you training. We have mock interviews. You can piggyback off anybody. Talk, ask questions. We're all here. What one doesn't know, the other does. So, you know, we're here. We're here. We're a family. We love each other. We're here to see each other grow and just expand our horizons. And, you know, before we leave, I would just like to say again, thank you for a marvelous first season of Delayed But Not Denied, the podcast. This has been one heck of a ride that I do all over again. 100 times over. I've enjoyed myself. I love the people. I love hearing people's different perspective on life and things that they deal with. So this is a family, and we would love to have you. And if you would like to be a part, please reach out to Miss Angela, the queen of collaborations herself. And let her help you. Let her get you started. And we will be back on tomorrow night where we will have everybody. And we're going to take 2023 out with a bang. So you don't want to miss it. 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Be here. Don't meet us here. Beat us here. So, you know, that's all I got. I love you all. I'm grateful for you guys. And I'll see you tomorrow night.
The book, A Song for Zipporah, written by David Harris, is a powerful historical fiction centering around the life and character of Moses' future wife, Zipporah, before they met. Book author David Harris brings the reader into the relationship between Moses and Zipporah, which was gradual and lush. The story unfolds beautifully when Moses finally asks Zipporah to marry him.